Hello, I'm back, ish. I guess hello Cambridge. It's where I moved to. Surprise. Hi, I'm back, ish. I have so many cool new video ideas. And just hi. Just kind of wanted to pop on and say hi, really, because it's been a while and it feels weird not making videos every week or like at all. So cool things that I've done. I'm all moved in, kind of. Well, all of my stuff is in the house, so I've moved in with a couple of friends, one of them from uni and his girlfriend, and we are just vibing in this house. It's really nice. So all my stuff is now here. My landlord from Nottingham was very kind and brought it all over for me. And he drove me, which is nice because in the Goodbye Nottingham video, if you haven't seen it, oh fuck, what size is it? This one? Oh, it's been a while. If you haven't seen that video, I was boarding the train and there was a will he, won't he be able to drive me and my stuff. In the end, he could drive me and my stuff, and I only did like a train commute once. Oh, that was a lot. I took like two big suitcases and a holdall, and then I had like a rucksack on my front. It was a lot because I just wanted to have enough stuff to like survive should he not be able to drive me. It was a lot. Lots of panic, anxiety, stress, just fun. It took like three trips to get all my stuff here, but here we are. Turns out I have a lot of things. I need to do another declutter soon, but that's very much future me because I'm quite tired. Let's go on a tour of my room, shall we? The lighting is about to get very weird. Another reason why I have been busy all of the weekends is because this room came unfurnished and now there is quite a lot of furniture that I have been building. So this is my door. This is a mirror. You know what a mirror is. Hello. Okay, let me just put my screen. There we go. Not all of it is tidy. The floor is okay. Needs a hoover. Where should we start? Okay, yes, this random thing of stuff. This other random thing of stuff. And we ignore the glass of wine, that's not there. My new desk. This is a very strategically placed hand because I have a drawing. Piece of artwork that's definitely not allowed on YouTube. Oopsie. I have a little coat closet thing. I don't shut the door because that's where Bob lives. It's my new wardrobe. It is a railing, as you can see. Medication and stuff and masks are down there. Socks and stuff. Pile of crap. Shoes. My new altar. I have two sets of drawers on completely opposite sides of the room because why not? So I've got all my incense-y stuff and the top bit. Also, this is just removed. This doesn't live here. There we go. A bookshelf with the green man with my Starbucks mug where I said, "Hey, I'm deaf. Can I have a hazelnut latte?" And they were like, "Yeah, sure." And then wrote "deaf" on the mug. Very awesome. Like a secondary kind of altar, but it's more like storage. More books, more books, more books. Pile of crap on the floor that we don't necessarily need. Basket of stuff. Bedside table. Bed that I built. Those are clean. Just couldn't be bothered to do anything. And my window where you were just sat watching me talk. Yeah, that's kind of it. It's my room. I put my medals up there because I like to remember the time when I was fit and could be bothered. And now I can't. So, what have I been getting up to? Just kind of work, really. You'll be pleased to hear I absolutely love my job. It's so much fun. I get to do cell culture like every day, which is great, and other sciencey things, which is also wonderful. Oh, birdie. We have a garden. We have a back garden. It's really, really cool. There's grass. I literally look out my window and there is so many trees, so much grass. It's fantastic. And then I have all my plants kind of in my windowsill. That one looks dead. It's not. It's just a little crunchy on the edges. I'm having a great time with work. And I thought maybe I might suffer a bit more, but I haven't so far, and everyone at work is really good with like pronouns and deafness and queerness and disability and everything. So for Deaf Awareness Week, I wrote a thing for like the internal newsletter about like, hello, Deaf Awareness Week, you also have a deaf scientist on the quad, so here is how to talk to deaf people and some facts about deafness. Just like very basic 101 type things, and it's Pride Month, so I just bought loads of flags and I just put them in the office. I was like, we're gay now, okay? And everyone was really like, yeah, okay, what are these flags? So I made like a little key, and now the office is gay, which is really nice. But yeah, everyone's been super supportive. And in terms of like disability and cold urticaria, everyone's been really, really nice. My manager has not pressured me into doing training for things that might irritate my disability. So like all the manual handling, lifting stuff, and he always comes down and makes sure that everyone's okay. And with cold urticaria, he didn't want to like say, hey, do you want to do liquid nitrogen training, in case it was a no. But I did the liquid nitrogen training, so I'm allergic to cold and I play with liquid nitrogen now. Not every day, not play with. I just use it very briefly, occasionally, for work-related purposes. I will be making a video on that at some point, because I just think it's wild that this is what I do now. After all my, I can't breathe outside, and then I just work with liquid nitrogen. But it's not like other people who aren't allergic to cold can just like dip their hands in. It's the same. I don't know. Workplace is great. Where I live now, which I will not be as forthcoming with now that there's 1,000 of you. By the way, hitting 1,000 while I wasn't here to celebrate it properly? Rude. But hello, 1,000 of you. I'm excited to keep making videos. But who knows when? What else? Other cool things that I have been doing, I have been scouting out tattoo artists, and I'm finally getting the bad one on my back removed. I had my patch test today. You can see there's a bandage. I am gonna be making a separate video about the tattoo removal process and all the things that go along with it. That's not really for this video, just wanted to mention it. And yeah, while I have been not YouTubing, I have been writing a lot of things. I've written for like our internal newsletter, but I've also been writing for, I wrote for the Limping Chicken, which is something I've wanted to do for a while. I shot my shot, as we say, and they were like, yes, we want this. So I'll put a link to that down in the description below. Cool things I bought this month. Oh God, you're gonna judge me so hard. Not a royalist. I just want to make that abundantly clear that I'm not a royalist. However, I bought the Swatch. You can't even see it. Come on. There we go. I bought the Swatch Jubilee watch. The Queen's outfit changes colour with the time. It takes about 2 weeks to go from start to finish. And there's 70 dots around the outside to celebrate one of each of her years on the throne, which makes time telling not great. I wanted a watch for a while, and it was my treat myself present for having a job that actually pays me money, which is nice. Yes, you can see Bob in the background, kind of. You can see his ominous looking shadow in the background. Obviously he's not here with me, so I have to have the picture of him as well as the tattoo. I've done a lot of things, so many things, mainly because I can afford to now. I will definitely be talking about like money and just how much not having any money really messed with me. Because I'm going to talk about weight gain for a second, so just if that's not a thing, I'll put a timestamp on screen. So yeah, I actually can afford to eat, so I have gained some weight, which is nice, which is really going to help with the decluttering, because I put on a jacket the other day and I was like, oh wow, this doesn't fit even a little bit anymore. So I can get rid of like all of my smaller size things that just don't fit, and that will just make the decision process of what do I throw away a lot easier. But it's really wild like how much of my like fatigue, I do still have chronic fatigue, but not chronic fatigue syndrome, because they're two different things, but how much of my fatigue was improved by like actually being able to eat enough. which is wild, and it definitely shouldn't be like that, but it is. So there is that, and it just, I don't know, it makes me feel a bit like sad, but I don't know, it makes me feel things that's how I lived for a long time, and now I just sort of, very privileged now to be able to just afford stuff, so I can go to the shop and if I want blueberries, I just buy blueberries. I don't have to think that, oh no, they're not on offer, can't afford them, oh well. So I can just, yeah, afford to eat. And all I do is eat now, which is really nice, because before, eating was like a chore. Last week at work, I started my day with a bagel, and then I got on the bus to work, which is an hour, and then I had a second breakfast of two bowls of cereal with soy milk. Then I had two lunches. I had leftover pizza from the night before, and then I had leftover curry also from the night before. And then I had a snack around 3, and then I got home and had another snack, and then I had dinner, and then I think I had a sharing bag of Doritos. Like, I ate a lot of food, and it was great. I like food now. I think a lot of my food issues came from like the guilt of, can I even afford this? But there we go, that's my dark train of thought for today. What else? Went to a bike show, because that's a thing. Oh, I also live an hour and 20 minute drive from a drag strip, so you can bet on it that there's gonna be like a camping. I'm going camping twice, once at the end of June, once at the end of July. One is drag racing, one is pagan-y, druid-y things. Oh, there's so many exciting things. And I can't promise that all of them will get the videos when they're happening, but they will be filmed. It's complicated because I'm just really enjoying life here and the moving process and work. Work is tiring, it is. I don't, like, it does kind of refuel and recharge me, but also they're long days and I am quite tired because I have to get up at 6, so I have to go to bed at 10, but I get home at 6, so there's like 4 hours, and I don't always want to film a video. And then weekends now, because I can afford to do things, I go and do things. But I'm gonna try and make one video a month. I can't promise. I want to make 2, because I genuinely still enjoy making videos. I'm just living in the moment, so you might just have to live with that. I think that's about it. I just wanted to pop in and say hi. Life is good, work is good. Video ideas, cold urticaria with liquid nitrogen, tattoo removals, moving house while disabled. I'll make a different video on that, because this is just a rambling hello. Oh, so many things. Pagan camp, doing a talk, be excellent. Drag racing, be excellent. Many things. Hello. I live in Cambridge now. Don't quite have a pride wall yet, but you know, maybe. We'll see. I need to do some work. I'm currently propped up on some books on a windowsill, so I need to figure out a lot of things. But life is good, and I'm back. I'm gonna bid you farewell. Sorry for just the rambling, this isn't really content, this is just saying hey. Thank you for 1,000 subscribers, that wild, absolutely wild, but I'm happy you're here. Welcome to the Ice Mice family. If you want to see any videos, let me know in the comment section below, and while you're there, don't forget to like this video. Something, drop a comment. Subscribe to my channel if you haven't already. This is not going to be the video that gets me subscribers, but we say it anyway. And ring that notification bell so you get notified every single time I post a new video, which you're going to need to do because I don't have a schedule. So you can't just remember my timings anymore. You actually have to press the button if you want to know when new videos are posted. Ha! Gotcha. Sorry. See ya.